Hello friends and colleagues, welcome to what's in this update. It is the 30th of May. It's quite a hefty update, 15 things updated. I've got the patch notes here and we are going to go through them to see what's improved. And yeah, so I'll just wait for it to load. Well, wait, my schedule for this week is as follows. So today we have the what's in the update video, then tomorrow we have the Spirit of Steam Liverpool to Crewe first look. Wednesday we have a how fast can steam trains go? Yep, I'm going to push them to the limits. First, we have a look at a scenario. Friday, Memoirs of Passenger Philip. And then Saturday will be a scenario that I've created. And then on Sunday will be a Jubilee run. So yeah, that's my schedule for this week. So let's get into the routes and have a look. So, core improvements. Route operation. After running for a red signal on a scenario, objectives should no longer fail to load after returning to the last checkpoint originally flagged on Cathcart Circle. Players should no longer be incorrectly put into a driving state when something blocks them from taking control of a service, either player permissions or AI train in motion. Loco display screen should now stay consistent with the speed the local is travelling at, originally noted on Haarlem Lime's M7A. PS4, whilst exploring on foot, pressing triangle/Y should no longer force the player to enter driver mode, originally noted on PS4 Bakerloo Line. Xbox, players should no longer crash after pressing in the right stick after standing, originally flagged on Xbox London Commuter in the class 377-387. Passengers. Platforms with service due should feel busier, whilst passenger volumes on other platforms should feel more appropriate. Fixed passengers getting stuck when trying to alight from a train that has a lower floor height than the platform, as well as getting stuck within the platform. Passengers should no longer be stuck on the platform facing the wrong direction, waiting to board a train that has already left. Interact with the same seat as another passenger on trains and platforms. Stutter when alighting the train. Controls. Fixed estimated service time in the timetable menu showing as negative if the start and finish time of the service are either side of midnight. Fixed gamepad navigation in mastery tier report boards. Fixed weight objectives not displaying title and description text. On the route map, when using the controller, the cursor should now properly snap to the nearest interactable object on the route map if the two objects are very close together or intersecting. Pressing the Open Interaction Shortcuts button whilst the menu is open will now close the menu. Livery Designer / Creators Club. Added ability to re-download uploaded content and resave it as local and editable. Added decals for Queen's Jubilee for livery designer as part of the logo selection. Let's have a look at that. This will be deleted anyway, so it doesn't matter. So, layers. Logos. Oh, is that it? Fair enough. Delete that so it's not running around. Cool. So let's get into some roots, hey? Abstract Orion Rule. So, let's put in at a station. Yes, sure, Essen. So, added contact signaler. What the heck's that? Added contact signaler functionality to trackside telephones. Get rid of motion blare. Changed light rain to fully raining on destination Duisburg and route introduction scenarios. Added functional level crossings to route. I don't know if there is any level crossings on this route. Actually, it might be on the S-Bahn line. Yeah, there. Yeah, on the S-Bahn line. Cool. Find out what that station is and walk down to the thingy. As you can see, new skies and PIS and track rendering distance. Let's find that station. removed any references in route introduction to engage with controls players cannot access. As you can see, new track rendering PIS on every station, as well as the beautiful new skies that we all love. Well, I like them a lot. As you can see, there's a new track rendering. I don't really care how long this video is, I just want to show everything off in detail. Nearly there, I promise. There we are, crossings are open. They definitely work. Wait here for a train to go past. Probably be waiting a while. Oh no, maybe not. Oh no, possibly. Yeah. But they definitely work. So we've looked at that. Rolling stock. Go to the menu. So for the rolling stook, so for the 442 we have added specific train formations in scenario planner. For the 425 we have reduced intensity of interior lighting. For the 101 we have AI trains were not running with passenger lights turned on, they now do. Updated name to improve experience in livery designer. Added missing Chinese translations. Fixed lock throttle after receiving from emergencies stop situation in route introduction. BR442 and to 425 we added rail driver functionality, not really important for me. 442 and 425 improved passenger lighting and resolved reflection of said lighting in the windows. 101 updated rail driver button mapping in the let's just spawn in randomly. Yeah, rail driver thing, and added contact signal and simple radio functionality. So let's get in and have a look at that. Where is it? So the red button. Don't think there's a telephone anywhere for that. Sorry. So yeah, that's the, probably the same for the other stuff. Let's have a look. I'll show you where to find it on the 442, because I'm nice like that. Wait for it to load. There it is. So it's not. Yeah, it's my telephone. So again, there's a possibly what the. Didn't know it's that before. Yep. Contact signal are there. In the 101 will probably be the telephone. The desk, but we're still spawning in the anyway. And yeah, just there. Cool. As I thought it would be. So, on to the next route that has been updated. Rosignord, my personal favourite German route. So we're spawning on foot at Hagen. So, route operations. Players should now be able to climb the platforms at any point rather than just designated locations. Added level crossings to be operational. Excuse that, it was just the cat. So, level crossings will be operational. Like the fully armed and ready battle station. That, you know, called the Death Star. Yep, so level crossings. I'm not gonna. I could spawn in there. And nice one. PIS for the docking stop, as you can see. PIS operational. Ah, double Hentis. Triple Hentis. No way. Oh man. Oh man, he's gonna love that. Well, added contact signal functionality to telephones, changed light raining to full raining weather for still gaze, Lamath light and fossil fuel scenario. Updated train shutdown objectives in Lamath light scenario to be clearer. Added a year date to the services in Chapter 4 of DBBR 363 journey road services, 11 to 13 should now work as intended. Awesome. Rush hour passengers, hello. In terms of art, updated route to support new skybox. Yes. Added dovetail live mastery reward explorable signal box. Hopefully it works. Updated ballast with white concrete sleepers. Added PIS to all stations and platforms. Added traffic to main routes on route. Fixed floating scenery outside entrance to signal box at Philanthrop Station. So, let's start off with the Doppelstock. So let's spawn in with the Doppelstock. Spawn in, we're not going to take it anywhere. Mm. So, as you can see, ballast has been updated there. So, we've got, where is it? Contact kind of functionality there. Wipers now start on park rather than off. Yep. Fixed issue whereby blue lights were coming through the roof of the train. Let's turn the lights on and have a look at that. Got to insert the reverser now, just like any other TSW route with double stock. Let's turn the train lights on. As you can see, no longer coming through the roof.
Excellent.
Spelling and translations improved. Cool. So, DBBR143, which is our next loco to be looking at. Spawning, there she is. Let's do Siegendhagen. got a few things to look at this. So, we now have PIS. Added contact signaler functionality and simple radio functionality with the telephone there. Added green glow to the PIS board. There we are. Installed PIS system, which we've just seen, and that is all for the 143. No point in showing you the 185.2, as that's nothing really. Changed program mode to U on the PZB service. Updated digital displays to display correct number on screen when starting PZB. DBBR 363. Updated livery design and aim to improve prayer experience. Updated controls for throttle and dynamic brake to be the correct way around the rail driver. Updated custom liveries previously not being selectable in timetables service. Let's have a check of that. Well, Alpha. Okay, maybe not, that's a lie. all locos updated rail driver don't matter. All locos remove lock on classic control lock in gameplay. Remove control locks during the tutorials to prevent unrecoverable situations. Passengers. Rush hour passengers behaviors added. Rush hour passengers volumes added. Passengers are now correctly populated platforms and embark disembark trains at Lamath. Timetable. Fixed missing line numbers for all terminating services. Added virtual stations to service mode and updated station directory. Next one, we move on to Rapido Transit. So we've got changed light rain to full, raining for metropolitan scenario. Car should no longer clip on road corners. So let's get in with a talent 2. Do that one. Changed PZB to 85-0 in default startup. Change that. Deleted rogue first class door, which causes players to be blocked. Recentered throttle brake to 0, so it's full centre for rail driver. Don't really have updated seating. Don't know what that means. Looks, don't look very updated, but for sure. Updated screen to show correct time of day, so it's 10:43:41. Yep, correct. Softened reflections in windows. Yep. I'll get to that in a minute. Added functionality for parking brake lighting. So there you go, you can see it lighting up now. Increased interior lighting for passenger compartments, let's put that on. As you can see. Updated livery design and aim to improve player experience, don't really care about that. Uh, Replaced old AFB system with updated AFB system. Interesting. There we are. Updated doors not opening and closing on double stock. Oh, that's 182, sorry. Oh, so shit. 182 was a new AFB system, my bad. Yes. Double stock, updated livery designer name, updated wipers to park, updated new PIS, updated sounds. Nice. So apparently it's got contact signaler functionality, same as the 182 and double stock. Cool. PIS, Talent 2 now has PIS. Passengers, rush hour passengers behaviours added, rush hour passenger volumes added, mastery added, dovetail live mastery awards, landing cargo plane. So let's have a look at mastery while we, before we go on to the other non-important stuff. Dovetail live mastery rewards. That's still broken. Oh, nothing. Interesting. Ignore that. Should be there. London commuter. Fast line scenario should now be completable on all platforms. Bakerloo. Headlights operation moved to button 28. Yeah, don't need that. Added contact signaler and simple radio functionality. That'll be the telephone on the front. Let's just check it is, because I don't want to be wrong. Don't want the old rush. Better to check, better to be safe than sorry, right? Maybe not. Interesting. Where would one contact signal from? Well, it seems like we can't actually contact signaler. Interesting. Turned it on it. Ignore that. AI trains were not running with passenger lights turned on, now they do. Sandy patch change likely running to misty weather in scenario 1 and 3. Improved operation of CSX CA40-8W's independent brake to work to correct pressures. Let's spawn in because I need to show you something. SD40. Improved operation of independent brake to work to correct pressure. You turd. That's my ears. Spesset Barn. So, main Spesset Barn had a problem in the double stock where the lights wouldn't work for some reason. Not sure why. So, added new updated cab controls to enable headlights, coach lights, and headlights to be operated. Put the reverse handle in, put the lights on. Brake key. So, there we are, yep. PIS headlights should be operational, which they are. Awesome. Yep. Coach lights should be on. Yes, everything operational. Update destination displays to show the piss. Added translation improvements. Keeping on main Spesset Barn, but going to a different loco. We have the... Where is she? Let's do this one. Updated locomotive thumbnail to remain consistent with other TSW2 content with added rail driver functionality. That little radio gets everywhere. Added simple radio and contactor signaller functionality, which is the little walkie talkie from Kerrico Mark 4. There's the one on this side, nope, should be, but alas there isn't. Next up we have Sherman's Hill. Smoothed landscape and lowered telephone poles around Cheyenne Rail Yard. Updated route name to allow it to fit into the route selection screen. Harlem Shake. We have updated service 775 to be completable by players. Can't remember which up more. Oh yeah, I know this one. It didn't work. But it's completable now, apparently. They've updated the route signs as well. The route name to allow it to fit into the selection screen. And finally, we have something else on Hapstaka Rain Raw. It's Rainbow Roston, isn't it? (Clears And they're like a G6. So we have updated safety system sounds to not being audible from outside. Update the issue whereby cruise control got reset by the C4 reset button. Change light rain to misty weather in a piece of cake scenario. Right. Now I've got to sort out the pesky. They need a rebuild. Discover the latest about Trains in World. Oh, not. Come on, laggy. Oh, so patch not. I don't like that. Today we're bringing you a sizable update for Trains in World 2, featuring some cool game improvements necessary for Spirit of Steam. Long-awaited press crew updates for Raspberry Transit abstract arrival was ignored, and some other misc fixes. There we go. So the rooks piss on abstract Ryan Raw. Got PIS for talent 2. I've got an idea. I've got an idea. I want to see if it works on other routes. So let's go to my favourite route. Test. Or tester. Let's go from St Pancras to Faversham. Calling it City Board only. Oh, doo doo. I'm an idiot, I forgot to press off the rails. Oh, this is gonna be funny. Faversham, calling it City Board only. I think this is it. Loaded. This is a test. Passenger service. This is going to be hilarious. This is just a test. So if I go to... the hell? I can't zoom in. There we are. Don't know what happened there. Oh, wow, it does. Ramsgate, Faversham, Tenham, Sittingbourne. Let's see. Oh my. As if. Okay, that's a bug. How much fun? Oh, and I think my PIS works in here. So I can't think. Wow. I've added some kind of film over the windshield. Yep. Pants up. Go. Ha 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 ha. I'm an evil genius. Anyway, that was just to test something. Let's look at mastery, see if it's worked. Still broken. Mastery is not showing up. Okay. Doesn't matter then. So, thank you all for watching. I hope you have enjoyed this look at what's in the update. And I hope to see you tomorrow and the rest of the week with Steam. Yeah, have a good one and enjoy your day. Thank you all for watching. See you tomorrow.